Hi, I'm Rachel from Pennsylvania, and I'm Amish. Please like and subscribe. The Amish community believes in a simpler lifestyle than the rest of the modern world, and this is reflected in our clothes and our simple ways of living. Some of us don't even have cell phones in the 21st century, including me. But I was always curious about the world and wanted to experience everything. Once when I was 5, I found a lost doll on my way to school, and in our culture, dolls aren't supposed to have faces, but this one did. I was thrilled to find it and took it to school with me. But as soon as I took it out of my bag, the kids screamed.
OMG, a doll with a face. Where did you get this thing from?
I guess it belongs to some tourist who must have visited the area and...
So you stole it from her?
No, she forgot and...
Just then, the teacher came running. She took the doll from my hands and tossed it into the dustbin. But I wasn't giving up so easily. After school, I snuck into the classroom and took the doll out of the bin. And then I heard the teacher's voice.
What do you think you're doing?
The teacher took me to the principal, and soon the news spread across the town that I was evil. But my parents didn't care.
I'm so sorry, Mom and Dad. I caused you trouble.
Oh, it's okay, honey. We know that you're a good girl who is just curious about things. You don't have to be sorry about anything, love. And then she hugged me real tight, but no one else liked me after that. Not much changed until I turned 16, and then it got worse, because this was the age that girls in the community started getting married, and I didn't want to. I was confident no one would ask for my hand in marriage since everyone thought I was evil, but to my horror, it happened. One day I had some guests over and my parents told me, "Oh dear, Jim has decided that he wants to marry you, and even we think you both are a great match. So, what do you say?"
Say? I didn't know what to say. I pulled the guy aside and asked him to say no.
"No, I can't do that."
"What? Are you crazy? They'll get us married if you don't."
"That's what I want, Rachel. I've been in love with you ever since I saw you and..."
Rachel, stop. Please listen to me. He was a sore loser and I didn't want to marry someone like him. I tried to talk to my parents, but they said it was for the best.
Really?
Now I had no option but to run away. I left home and kept running until I reached the main road. And there I saw a bus approaching me. The bus stopped and some kids got down. And that's when I saw the most shocking thing. A girl just like me was standing right in front of me.
What the freaking pigeon?
She looked just as shocked and walked towards me. "Wow, you look just like me. That's so amazing. I'm Lindsay. What's your name?"
"I'm Rachel."
"Well, Rachel, your clothes? They look so cool. Where did you get them from?" I don't know why, but I told her my entire life story, and suddenly Lindsay smiled at me and told me this crazy idea. "Rachel, do you want to trade places with me?"
"What?"
"Well, I want to see your community, and maybe I'll get some time off my stupid life, and you get to live the life you want out there." Well, I was speechless. I was really scared to do it, but when I thought about the marriage proposal waiting for me at home, I said, "Yes!" Rachel and I exchanged our clothes, and it felt so different. All these colors on my body were crazy. Suddenly, the bus honked, and Lindsay told me to get on it. She hugged me and said goodbye, and ran back towards the direction I pointed her to. I got on the bus, and it was all so weird. All the kids were calling me Lindy, and she seemed to be a super popular girl. But then suddenly, a girl came to me and slapped my face really hard.
"What the heck?"
"This is the last time you kiss my boyfriend. You hear me?"
"Her what?"
I was in shock. I'd never kissed anyone. But then I realized probably Lindsay did. I didn't know what to do, so I just went to the back and sat there. When we reached the school, a lady standing by a car waved at me.
"Lindsay, how dare you go on this trip without informing me? And why are all your teachers telling me you're a brat?" That's enough. Not another word from you. I'm taking away your phone, young lady."
"My phone? I don't have a phone." Lindsay probably took it with her, and her mom looked furious now. She asked me to get into the car, and just as we reached home, she said,
"You sneaked out when you were grounded, And now I'm extending your punishment. You're not leaving this house for another week.
OMG, this was like back to where I started from. Lindsay's mom sent me to her room, which was mine now. And this room was full of things I'd never seen in my life. A TV, a computer, a closet full of colorful clothes. This place was heaven. And then I jumped onto her super soft bed and fell asleep. Suddenly, I felt like I was kissing someone in my dream. But I screamed my lungs out when I realized it wasn't a dream. There was a boy in my room kissing me. He tried to hush me and said in a low whisper,
"Why are you screaming? It's me, Toby, your boyfriend."
Boyfriend? Lindsay betrayed her boyfriend and kissed some other guy? She was really something. Suddenly, he came closer, and I could even see in the dark how handsome he was. But what are you doing here this late?
I come here every day, ever since you've been grounded, remember? What's wrong with you, babe?
He touched my forehead so gently, I couldn't help but melt a little. Then he took out a beautiful necklace from his pocket.
I bought this to mark our first month together. Shall I put it on you?
He was doing all this for Lindsay, who betrayed him for some other guy? For a moment, I started to hate her. I decided I was going to tell him that I wasn't Lindsay. But just then, I heard her mom walking upstairs.
Lindsay, I heard some noises. Are you okay?
Toby and I looked at each other, super scared, but he quickly ran out of the window, and both of our butts were saved.
Were you talking to someone?
No, of course not. I don't even have my phone on me.
I left it on the field trip, remember?
She looked at me suspiciously and then went away. A few days passed, and I was just stuck at home. All thanks to Lindsay, the brat. But thank God for Toby, who visited me every day. And every time I wanted to tell him the truth. But I was afraid he'd get mad and stop seeing me. One night when he dropped by, he got up to leave after 20 minutes. I asked him why, and he said,
"Babe, I play volleyball at the beach every Saturday night, remember?"
The freaking beach? I leapt up excitedly and said I wanted to go with him. He looked really surprised.
"But you hate the beach and the sand and volleyball. And you also hate my friends and never want to hang out with them?"
Wow, what was wrong with Lindsay? Oh, I guess I've just been cooped up for so long. I really just want to go out. He looked super happy and we both snuck out the window. I had to stop myself from gasping when I saw the sea for the first time. It was so beautiful. I had an amazing time with his friends. And after his game, we took a moonlit walk on the beach. I closed my eyes to feel the wind in my hair. And when I opened them, I saw Toby looking at me curiously. He stopped and took my hand.
"Lindsay, I don't know what it is, but something about you has changed. You're enjoying all these things you never do with me. And you even look different. I haven't seen you much without makeup. And I have to say, you're even prettier this way."
And with that, he pulled me in close and kissed me. And I just couldn't help kissing him back, even though I felt so guilty. I'd been so caught up with Toby, I hadn't even thought that much about Lindsay, and I decided to check up on her. I sneaked into her mom's bedroom one evening and took her cell phone. I found Lindsay's contact there and called her, but she just cut my call. I tried again, and she kept rejecting it. Ugh, this girl! Then I sent her a text message saying it was me, Rachel, and then she replied with a picture. What? No, this girl was insane. Suddenly, I turned around to find Lindsay's mom standing right behind me.
"You're not Lindsay, are you?"
What? How did she know that? Suddenly, she put her hands around my face.
"You guys look so alike. I can't even tell you apart."
"What are you talking about? Do you know who I am? And who are you?"
"My name is Sabrina. I grew up in an Amish community. But I never felt connected to anyone in it, except for my sister, your mother."
She was my mom's sister?
"At the age of 20, I got pregnant with twins, and I knew my sister could never have any children. So before leaving town, I gave you to her."
Wait, what? So you're my mother?
"Yes, but that doesn't mean my sister isn't. She loves you more than me, I'm sure."
"Of course she does. She didn't leave me like you did. And you're a terrible woman. I can't believe you abandoned me and thought of only yourself. I hate you." I just got up and ran out of there like crazy. It was raining heavily and I kept running until I bumped into someone. Toby.
"Lindsay, are you okay? What happened?"
I was so out of breath, I couldn't speak. I started to cry, and Toby hugged me tight and took me to his home. After some time, he gave me some hot chocolate to drink, and while I was drying myself by the fireplace, Toby came and hugged me from behind.
Lindsay, it's okay if you don't want to tell me anything, but I want you to know that I'm falling in-
Toby, stop! I turned around and he looked confused.
Is everything okay?
No, it's not. I'm not Lindsay. I told him everything about the switch and even that Lindsay cheated on him. You're a good guy, Toby, and you deserve so much better. I'm sorry I didn't tell you sooner. Toby stood there stunned. I hugged him tight and left. It was almost dawn and I decided I was gonna go back and stop Lindsay from ruining her life. But just then a car stopped in front of me and Sabrina jumped out.
Rachel, there isn't a day that I haven't thought about you.
It was really tough for me, but I don't regret what I did. My sister is a very good human being and she deserved happiness. And you, tell me, would you give her up as your mother? Suddenly, I realized that she was right. My mother was amazing, and I was so wrong to leave her like that. I turned to Sabrina. We have to leave now. Lindsay is getting married. She drove with the speed of light, and when we got to the farm, I ran to my house, and there, I saw Lindsay kissing Jim in the front yard. Lindsay, stop! Are you crazy? Jim looked at me like he'd seen a ghost and ran away like crazy.
Everyone was right. You're a witch. A witch!
What are you doing here? And Mom, I swear I didn't do it. It was Rachel's idea to switch places.
No, it wasn't. You've got to stop with these lies and stupid things that you do.
I can't believe we're sisters.
We're what?
Sabrina told her everything as she stood there in complete disbelief. Just then, Mom came out and hugged Sabrina. Oh, sis, it's been so long. I missed you so much. And then she turned to me and pulled me close. Rachel, my child, I heard everything and I'm so sorry, honey. I should have told you that I'm not your mom. No, you are. You are my mom and I love you. I shouldn't have fled without telling you. I like my life with you and Dad, but Mom, I just wanted to see more.
You were always a curious one.
Sweetheart, if that's what you want to do, you can have it. And there will always be a home for you here to come back to. As I hugged Mom tight, suddenly Lindsay let out a loud squeal.
OMG, Toby, baby, what are you doing here? Did you come all this way for me?
He gently pushed her aside.
No, I didn't, Lindsay. We're over. You can kiss or marry whoever you want.
He pulled me to the side and said,
I came here for you. You didn't let me finish my sentence earlier. I wanted to tell you that I'm falling in love with you. With you, Rachel. And if you're moving to the city, I'd love to ask you out on a proper date.
I'd really like that. And I love you too, Toby.